Hi, this is Hadas from Canva. Welcome to my channel. In this tutorial, I'd like to introduce to you Canva Docs, the newest and exciting feature that Canva has just launched. And in a few minutes, I will also introduce to you the newest feature that has been added to Canva Docs. So let's go ahead and see how we get started. First of all, if you still do not have Canva Docs, don't worry, just head over to canva.com/docs right here and sign up for Canva Docs. It'll take about an hour or two and you'll have it. So to begin, let's go to the suite and click on the Docs icon. You can also click down here on Docs and get some beautiful templates ready-made for you to design. So I'm just going to click on that, and as you can see, I get this blank white page, but it's not exactly blank. Let's go ahead and pick a template and see how we work around. Okay, I'm just going to pick this one. And as you can see, I have a table, I have text, I have photos, I have a banner. Let's start with a banner. You can edit this banner and change it or replace it with anything you'd like. Let's just click on it, see that it gets that frame around it, and then head over to Edit Design. Once you click on that, you will get another sub window. And here you can edit the banner. So I can change anything, whether it's colors, text, elements, images, whatever you'd like. Hit the Save button and you're back to your editing screen. See? There it is. Now let's go ahead and change a few of our text. I can change the colors of my banner. Let's go ahead and change everything to turquoise. And in one click, change all. Let's scroll down and see if mission is accomplished. There it is. So I'm just going to go ahead and change a few text boxes. You can create links, you can copy and paste, you have this floating menu right up here. And here I have this table. I can change the photos, I can change the text. Just click on these three dots, whether it's vertical or landscape, and change the cells accordingly. So I'm just going to delete this table because I want to show you how to use the plus button. Once you click on that, or you can also hit the slash button on your keyboard, you get this magic shortcut. You can add so many things into your Canva doc. For example, if I click the design option, I will get these beautiful banners that I can add in addition to the banner I already adjusted. I can also add photos. And for example, if I want to add a workshop photo, I can just click on it and I can resize it and it will automatically be adjusted to the doc. Now, what else do I have here? Okay, so I can add a table, I can add a checklist. Ooh, yeah, checklist. You can also add emojis, our all favorite emojis. You can also add charts, whether it's a pie chart, bar chart, line chart. You can also add a timer, which is super efficient if you're working or collaborating with other teammates and you'd like to set some timer. You can also add your logo if you've added it to the brand kit. So here I have another table, which as you can see, I can adjust accordingly. And now let's go ahead and see what else we can do with the Canva doc. Once I want to share this, I have a few options. One is hit the share button, and then you can share this with your team members, or maybe just add in an email of someone that is not in your team. What you can also do is download this. And once you hit the download button, you can pick the size, whether it's A4, A3, letter, or legal size. Then hit the download button, and there you have it. But do notice, when you were editing this, this was one long white canvas. Once it's downloaded, then it is divided to A4 in my case, which is the type that I chose. So make sure that you see exactly where your new page begins and ends. Another option is to convert this Canva doc, and you can convert this into a presentation. Let's hit the convert button and see what happens. Automatically, Canva has adjusted and converted my document into a presentation. I can choose a style from these options on the left. And let's pick one just for demonstration and click on Create My Presentation. And boom, there it is. Now, of course, you can edit this and adjust this, whether it's text, colors, styles, whatever you'd like. Let's see what it looks like. But this is definitely a huge shortcut when you want to create a document and then turn it into a presentation. You can use the Styles button, which is now under Design, and change the colors of one slide or all slides. And now it looks totally different. So just play around with it. Now, one important thing I also want to show you is that you have the option to click on the Insights. You can see how many words you have in your document, the read time, the characters. You can see how many views you had in this document once you shared it with someone. And you can also track the engagement. You can also create real-time collaboration. All the good stuff that you already know from Canva. Here comes the new feature that Canva has added. Canva has developed an AI feature, an artificial intelligence feature, which is called... What this does, it actually helps you with any writer's block that you may have and gives you something to start with when you need to write some kind of paragraph. Let's see how that works. I click on the plus button or the slash on my keyboard, and there it is, the magic write. Now, this works best at the moment with English, but in the future, it will be available to other languages as well. So here I can start and describe the topic that I want to write about. Try and be as specific as you can so you can get the most accurate text from Canva. You can also use examples and some inspiration from Canva by clicking here on the right side. So I'm just going to go with something like a cover letter to promote myself as a marketing expert. Let's see what happens. Just a few seconds and the magic happens. Ta-da! Not bad. I like it. Okay, now you can edit this, and I recommend that you do. This is just a suggestion. This is just a tool to help you get started. So make your adjustments and refine the text. This is a free feature, but you should know that if you have a free account, then you have 25 pieces of content for a lifetime. If you have a pro account, then you can use 75 pieces of content per user per month. Huge difference. So if you think that you're going to use this more than 25 times in a lifetime, you can always try out Canva Pro. And I remind you that by scanning my link or clicking my link at the comments below, you can enjoy 45 days of Canva Pro for free, no strings attached. One more amazing thing that I want to share with you is the option to embed a presentation within your Canva doc. The way to do that is, let's say I have this presentation and just click on share a link to view, copy the link, and go back to your Canva doc. Now all you have to do is click on the plus, hit the paste button, and there you get your presentation. It will be live and available for anyone who views your Canva doc. This is a great way to make your static document a live one. So I'm sure that Canva Docs is just going to level up and upgrade as we go along. Let me know in the comments if you like this, and I'll see you all in the next tutorial. Bye for now.